Woo!
Yeah.
What's going on, my Vinnies? It's your favorite robot, Vincaso Jones, back with another video. And I'm sure you don't need me to tell you this. It's been the talk of the town since it's happened, really. Of course, I'm speaking about the tragedy that was the death of Kobe Bryant and his daughter Gigi on a helicopter crash last Sunday. When I first heard the news, I actually cried for a bit, because Kobe Bryant was a big part of my childhood. I really don't know how else to say that. Kobe was a big reason why I took up the game of basketball as a child. And a lot of people don't understand the importance of sports. I mean, of course, there's the immediate benefits like getting fit and being more active, but there's a lot more to it. Basketball gave me a reason to wake up in the morning. It gave me the motivation that I still carry today through the various projects that I take part in. Basketball put me in a group of like-minded individuals with a common interest and gave me friends. Friends that I still talk to this day. It made me feel accepted. And you know, hearing that the person that got you into playing basketball in the first place passed away in such a horrible way was very hard. So I was going through Twitter the other day and I came across this post about Kobe Bryant's wife, Vanessa. And it made me feel two things, anger and just overall disgust. Honestly, when I first heard the news, one of the first thoughts that came to my mind was making a video about it so that I can be one of the first people to tackle the subject and people will view my video, and when they search it, I'll be one of the first videos that comes up. And that's a bad mindset. I realized that I don't want to be that type of content creator. I don't want to be that guy that literally does things purely for likes and reposts. I mean, it's a different story when it's positive news, but when it comes to this, I wasn't going to do it. But after seeing these various news outlets that completely disregard the privacy of people grieving, I just had to rant about it. Articles like half a page filled with things that we either already know or things we don't need to know because we can just assume. Kobe Bryant's wife, Vanessa, is struggling to keep it together and can't finish a sentence without crying. Well, yeah, she just lost her daughter and husband on the same day. An article wasn't needed. Vanessa is devastated. She can hardly keep it together, the source said. She can't finish a sentence without crying. But she is working very hard to pull it together for the other girls. That's literally what you said in the first paragraph. She now has to be the strong one. What? Kobe's wife is surrounded by people who love her and love Kobe, the source added. She has a good support system. She is relying on her faith. She is not alone. But she will be grieving this for a very long time, a family friend added. It's an extremely difficult and devastating time for Vanessa and the whole family. Kobe's surviving daughters are reeling too, the source said. Okay, so you guys see my point. This article didn't need to exist. It was made by some cricket media outlet that needed clicks for a quick buck. Here's another example. This is LeBron James getting off the Lakers plane the day of the accident. He just heard about Kobe, and as soon as he steps off the plane, there's a freaking drone recording him crying and hugging the people around him. This is what I mean. Have we become so desensitized as a society that basic emotions like sadness and grief can't be left alone? Let the man grieve in peace. One of his best friends just died. So the BBC issued an apology for posting the video, but honestly, I don't care. The only reason they apologize is because they received backlash. A lot of people ask me why I wear the robot head, and this is a perfect example of why I do. I came to the conclusion a while ago that I don't want to be famous. I don't want my face everywhere and to be known whenever I walk into a room. I think there's good people out there, but as a whole, society is filled with insensitive jerks who don't know and don't understand boundaries. And I don't want to be a part of that. So anyways, thank you guys for watching. Please continue sending love to the families of those lost in the helicopter crash. Be kind and have a great day.